And hello again, YouTube. It is still Saturday, the 14th of May, 9:05 a.m. After 9 o'clock in the morning, Priscilla still hasn't made her way home. So I guess we're back to that. Anyway, my early morning adventure was a lot of fun. I did not get mugged. I actually had a really great time. So, yeah. That's all I got to say on that subject. So, I was going to go home and just try to go to sleep, but I'm fairly awake, so I figure I may as well head out and do something useful with my day. I'm assuming by now the Discount Tire is open, so I should probably start with that. Although I should probably get myself a little bit of cash from the bank first, since I pretty much deposited everything before going to hang out with a random stranger. So, car's still shimmying. It doesn't happen until about 70 miles per hour now, as opposed to before it was doing it about 60, but still, it's not good. So I'm thinking I need to head to Discount Tire, have them rotate and balance the tires and give them a little more thorough inspection. And I'm crossing my fingers that all that's wrong with the car is, as far as the shimmy, all that's wrong with it is the tires. I can't imagine that the shimmying in the car has anything to do with the engine work that I still just had done. You know, the new engine that I had put in there. New used engine. Rob told me what kind of a car it came out of, and I forget what year, but it was out of a Chevy Malibu. So, oh, this looks crooked again. Is that better? No. I really need to get me a proper dash cam for shooting these ones in the car. It just seems like no matter how much I mess with this phone mount, it's always just a little crooked. Also, I got that CD that I made for the woman whose name I can never freaking remember that tends to hang out over at Wander Inn on Saturday morning. So, I want to head over there, but I think I should go to Discount Tires first. It's definitely the more important of the things I'd like to do. And it would certainly be nice to, I can't believe a line for the ATM. Holy crap. Ain't that something? I am not used to there being this kind of a line for the drive-up ATM here. That's kind of wild. It'd probably be a whole lot quicker to go to the one at hopefully I can get out of here. Quicker to the one over at 32nd Street. This is ridiculous. I have never seen a line like that for the freaking drive up ATM. And oh my gosh, this is so crooked. Beep. Let's go over to the one on, it's actually, there's one over by the, over in the strip mall over near, oh my God, what's the name of the tool place? I totally forget the name of the tool store. The cheap tool store over at 32nd Street, Harbor Freight. Yeah, 32nd Street in Thomas, which is right over by where Discount Tires is. So. In fact, come to think of it, it's probably more practical to just go to Discount Tires, and while they're working on my car, walk over to that ATM. Hey, that'll make the maximum use of my time. Yeah. So, I also got another box of recycling to take over to my storage. You know, I was thinking I would crush some of that down, and I realized I'm wearing flip-flops, so yeah, that's not happening. So one thing I did do this morning, other than wasting time with a stranger, I decided to top off my gas tank on the way home, since Costco had just opened, and I forget what it cost for a tank of gas, but holy crap, it was almost $50, which... You know, I'm sure if you drive an SUV or a truck, you're like, only $50. Lucky you. But I don't know. It doesn't seem that long ago that $15 topped off this car's tank. So yeah. Is what it is. Just kind of, I got so many mixed feelings about the increasing gas prices. I mean, as somebody who's driving again, yeah, it sucks. But if it results in some public transit improvements, some notable public transit improvements, I can kind of get behind that as a greater good. So, oh wow, some police activity going down on the left here. Wow, there's a lot of police activity going down there in front of the Home Depot. It almost looks like they're cracking down on people loitering in the parking lot trying to get day labor work. Oh, this is so crooked. It just seems like no matter how I turn this looks crooked. Well, that guy, he looks like he's really struggling to get across the crosswalk. With a stolen shopping cart. I don't think that person's homeless either. I'd be willing to bet money he lives over in Pine Towers. I think that's what it's called. The retirement home just to the north of here that my younger daughter's mother used to be a resident manager at. This freaking still looks crooked to me. Wow. Whoa. Wow. So I was just looking, and In-Groove Records is now called Stamp something. Oh, I just drove right by Discount Tire. Whoops. I wonder what all the cones on the side of the road are about. Some kind of construction going on here. Oh, there's that white bicycle I've been talking about that I kept saying I was going to make a video about, and I haven't. Yeah. Little monument, little memorial for Jesse the cook at Hideaway. Yeah, I don't think I'm ever going to be able to drive through that intersection again without immediately thinking of him getting killed and hit and run, just simply trying to ride his bike home from work. I'm not even sure why I'm running video right now. I really don't have a lot on my mind I'm trying to talk about at the moment, which I guess is a good thing. I am doubling back to see what the heck happened to InGroove Records. In fact, I kind of want to step out and feel like I probably should have turned right on that street to get there, but I'm going to double back and take this street here. 35th Street. I had a good friend I was trying to get to, he was looking to buy a duplex. I was trying to get him to buy into this neighborhood. And he ended up buying into West Chandler, which I think has worked out really well for him as well, but I don't think that property is appreciated nearly as much as the properties in this neighborhood here have. Meanwhile, I'm still renting. Yes, a sign here says collectibles, trading cards, Snapcasters Gaming. But they still have like all these giant murals of popular album covers. And Black Sabbath and Wu-Tang Clan and Run-DMC and the Beatles and the Rolling Stones tongue. I'm going to go ahead and keep this video running just so it's one continuous video, but I'm going to run real quick and look in the front of the store and see if there's a sign saying anything about InGroove Records moving. I can't imagine InGroove Records shutting down. That place was really thriving. Like, it got talked about a lot in R Vinyl on Reddit as they did online sales, and it's kind of a destination that people who are on vacation would come to Phoenix to check out as a really good record store. Never been a huge fan of this place, but it just, I don't know, their prices always seem a little high for what they have, but I mean, it's pretty normal for a lot of record stores. Although one time I came through here and I dug through their bargain bin, and I found Frank Zappa Apostrophe. Now, granted, it was kind of a beat-up copy. I'd say it's probably G+, you know. But it was a dollar. It was a dollar. I will happily buy a beat-up Zappa album for a dollar. It was a very listenable copy. Had some crackle. Whatever. Zappa sounds fine to me with a little surface noise. Anyway, enjoy the Pearl Jam. I'm definitely getting a copyright copyright block here. And I'm going to see what the hell happened to InGroove Records. Hopefully they got a sign in front of this building. I don't know what the heck to think about that. Yeah, there's definitely not a record store in there anymore. And there's no sign mentioning what happened to InGroove Records. I'm definitely going to have to do a little Googling to find that out. I honestly, as much as I think their owner is kind of a goob on YouTube, and as much as I was not overly thrilled with the store, I still like there to be as many record stores as possible. So I'm hoping he just relocated somewhere else. As far as what's in the space where In Groove Records was, it kind of looks like a bingo hall in there. Just a whole bunch of just rows of big tables with chairs down both sides of them. And then there's some display cases at the far end of the store. So I don't know really what to think about that. But wow, really shocked to see In Groove Records not there. You know, and he has had a pretty solid following on YouTube under the, I think the channel name is also In Groove Records. Mostly just talking about, just comparing different pressings of the same record, which, I mean, I understand it can make a difference, but for me, if I got the album, I got the album, I'm happy with it. You know, like I said, I was quite happy to pick up a kind of a crackly copy of, with a kind of beat up cover of Frank Zappa Apostrophe. That works for my collection. And then again, I'm the guy that's happy to listen to 8-track tapes. Anyway, I'm a Discount Tire. Thanks for coming with on the ride, and like and subscribe for more of my boring life.